A confounding turn of events in court yesterday. Michael Flynn before the judge, a harsh rebuke from a federal judge. Now General Flynn has to await his fate. Michael Mukasey, former attorney general, federal judge, back with us, and nice to see you.
Nice to be here.
I don't know what happened yesterday. You called it weird.
I did. Confounding is one word, weird's another. It's shorter. Inexplicable behavior, principally, from the judge. Let's take a step back. Going in yesterday, we had a defendant who had an exemplary record, charged with a crime where the guideline was 0 to 6 months, the government recommending no time. Everybody believed, I think reasonably, that this sentence would be imposed and that it would be no time. Judge came out, started to talk about how disgusted he was with the defendant's conduct, with Flynn's conduct, including referring to a matter where he said he sold out the United States. If he was referring to his service before he went to the White House as a lobbyist for Turkey, that wasn't charged. He didn't plead guilty to it, and it didn't take place while he was at the White House. So he had to climb back from
that. Here's what I'm trying to piece together, and you and I have talked about
this. The reference to treason was totally inappropriate.
Well, a reference to treason that he later had to take back after the break, and the reference to doing lobbying work in the White House when it ended in mid-November, which was... That was not factual, and that had to be cleaned up by the judge as well. Earlier this week, Flynn's team came out and they said, this was not on the up and up, but none of that was presented yesterday, none of it was argued. I'm just wondering, Dershowitz makes the point that the judge feels that Flynn is responsible for a much more serious crime than he pled to. If that is true, if you accept Dershowitz's argument, tell us. But if that is the case, why is that the judge's call?
I don't know whether it's the case. I don't read minds, but it's not the judge's call. And a judge is permitted on sentence for one crime to consider what's called relevant conduct, meaning including uncharged crimes, but they've got to be relevant to the crime to which he pleaded guilty. If he's concerned about the Turkish lobbying, that's not related to the false statements. So that is something that should not be considered on sentence. And if says he's going to consider it, that raises a real problem.
Here's the quote from the judge. He said, "I can't hide my disgust, my disdain for your criminal offense. Not only did you lie to the FBI, you lied to senior officials in the incoming administration." I imagine he's entitled to his opinion, but I just wonder where that wasn't the case.
It wasn't the case. And
so why does it come up?
Well, it comes up because the judge decided he couldn't restrain himself. And part of being a judge, as I recall it, is restraining yourself.
He suggested that Flynn has to cooperate more. Cooperate on what? And who's to say the level of cooperation hasn't already reached that point?
It's the government's say on whether the cooperation has reached that level already
or
not.
But that's why they reached the sentencing point, because the cooperation level was met, true or not?
I assume it's true. I don't know for a fact what the cooperation was. I know that for the government to recommend no time in a situation where, as I said before, you've got somebody with an exemplary record coming in on a first offense with a recommendation under the guidelines without cooperation is 0 to 6 months. The government, in essence, was giving away ice in the wintertime when they recommended no jail. And in the ordinary course, he wouldn't get any time. So when they say, well, we're going to recommend no time, in the ordinary course, the likelihood would be that there would be no time, but the judge was convinced that there was something going on that he didn't know about, and that's not his business.
Any aspects of collusion that you found yesterday?
Zero. Zero. No evidence, no reference to anything that suggested collusion in the sense in which we've been using it here, that is, some criminal relationship between the Trump campaign and the Russians and the Russian effort to influence the 2016 election. We haven't seen anything concrete about that.
Last question. Flynn's back before the judge, I think, in March, mid-March. Does he go to jail at that time?
Short answer, I don't know. I think that will afford an opportunity for everybody to kind of take a deep breath and a time out and perhaps have a determination that he's cooperated enough, after all, not to get jail. But I think yesterday was a really bizarre and ugly incident.
March 13th is the date on the calendar. Michael Mukasey, thank you, sir. Nice
thank
to
you.
See you. 2 days in a row.